With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Assertion: the difference in the value of acceleration due to gravity at pole and equator is proportional to square of angular velocity of Earth. So let's say this is Earth. Now, for a particle at the equator, there are two forces acting. There's a force due to gravity and an outward force, that is centripetal force, m omega square r. For the particle at the poles, the force due to gravity is still the same, but since it is at the axis, so this centripetal force is not applicable there. So the difference in the force at pole FP minus F equator is F minus F minus m omega square r. That means delta F is equal to m omega square r, which means delta F is proportional to omega square, that is square of angular velocity of Earth. So assertion is true. The reason says the value of acceleration due to gravity is minimum at the equator and maximum at the pole. So as we just proved, at the equator, the net force that is acting, F net, will be equal to F minus m omega square r. This is equator. And at the poles, F net P will be equal to simply F. So we can see that at the poles, the force is maximum, while at the equator the force is minimum. So the value of acceleration due to gravity is minimum at the equator, yes, and maximum at the pole, yes. So this statement is also true. But as we just saw, the reason that it is the reason for the difference in value of acceleration due to gravity at pole and equator is because the centripetal force is not applicable at the poles while it is applicable at the equator. So the assertion reason both are true, but the reason is not the correct explanation for assertion. That is option number B.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubtnet app today.